If you're anything like me, your mind is full of mental clutter, from remembering to-do lists to worrying about the past, thinking about the future, trying to remember your sister's birthday. It can be extremely overwhelming. So today we're going to talk about different strategies to help untangle our thoughts and get mentally organized. Welcome back. For those of you who don't know me, my name is Nena, and I'm a life coach that specializes in personal development. Here at this channel, we talk about everything having to do with our emotional well-being, understanding our own psychology, and living our best life possible. So if you aren't already a subscriber, please take a moment and become one, because we definitely want you to stay connected. So you feel like you have 1,000 things to do and that you're getting pulled in a million different directions. You feel like you're forgetting something, but you don't really know what it is. I have totally been there. This is something I've been struggling with my entire lifetime, pretty much, but I finally come up with some strategies that actually really work. So I wanted to take a moment to share those with you today. So the first part of this process is sitting down and doing what we call a brain dump. So what happens here is we're going to write down every little thing that is taking up mental space for you. So all the things that you are worried about, all the things that are stressing you out, the pesky little annoyances, the things that you are trying desperately to remember, your goals, your dream, just anything that is taking up any mental space, you want to take a moment and write it all out. Give yourself enough time that you can put down every possible thing that you've been thinking about. So this is going to help us from sitting at night and just wondering if we got everything accomplished and trying to remind ourselves about something we have to do the next day. And it's something that we need to do on a regular basis. So I like to do this on Sunday night so I can kind of get prepared for the week. So I just kind of let go of everything, write it all down. And then the second part of this is that we've got to actually kind of sort through all of these things. We then have to categorize everything. So I like to do this at first by circling things. So I have a few different color markers and I separate into different categories. So the things I am worried about, the things that I have to get done tomorrow, the things that I have to get done within the week, long-term goals, family issues, whatever it is, all the different things that could be little categories for you, you want to kind of circle out and separate. And from there, you can make smaller lists. So it's important when we're making these smaller lists that we kind of edit in the process. So we don't want to drag things onto our smaller lists that are really not holding value for us or really aren't important, or things that are realistically never going to get done. Not because they couldn't get done, but because they're really not that important to us anymore. So we want to make sure that the things that are making the cut are the things that are actually important. And if it makes you feel better to make a someday list, go ahead and write those down on a someday list, but take that someday list and get it out of eyesight, because just having it there often really stresses us out, because it just looks like a lot of things that we need to accomplish, and these are probably things that aren't going to get done. So from there, we can start to set priorities. So we want to look at every single list and see the things that are most critical to do and decide right then when we plan to actually do these things. That's going to make us feel a lot better because we feel like we are addressing them. It's also helpful if you have a daily list and then a list for the week. So with a daily list, you want to only include the things that you can, again, realistically accomplish within that day so that you are not feeling overwhelmed. But then we want to look at all the things that we circled that had to do with worry, that had to do with the things that are stressing us out or that are concerns for us. We want to think critically about all the things that we wrote down and ask ourselves if there are any actionable steps that we could potentially take to make these things a little bit better. Because when we don't address worry, it often starts to become anxiety. So anxiety is usually just a sign that there are things that we are worried about that have not been addressed. So we want to start to solution find. Are there things that we could do to start alleviating this worry? And if there are, we need to not only think of the strategy, but we want to go ahead and put it on the to-do list. and make it a must to do, because there is no worse feeling than having that worry and anxiety kind of floating with us throughout the day, especially when there is something we can actually do about it. So even if you feel that what you can do is very, very small, it actually gives us a great sense of control. Feeling that we are contributing at least to a solution gives us a lot of peace of mind. My next tip is to go ahead and declutter your space if it is messy, because it does not matter how much we untangle our thoughts, we are never going to feel completely at rest if everything is, you know, out of order around us. It is a simple fact that outer order leads to inner calm. So if you are feeling everything is kind of jumbled up in your life, you want to take a look at your external space and see if that is actually contributing to it. Another thing that we can do is to regularly journal. So it's important, like I said, to at least once a week kind of have these brain dumps where you kind of just get through everything that you're thinking about and organize it and sort it out and see what is deserving your focus and what is just mental clutter. But it's also important to, on a daily basis, be keeping a journal of your thoughts and your feelings and your goals and your dreams and, you know, all the things that add value to your life. I personally like to just take a few minutes in the morning and in the evening to just jot down my inner feelings and what my focus is and what kind of a day I had and what kind of day I want to have. And it really helps me stay in line with how I want the direction of my day to actually go. Another important thing is to make sure that we are not trying to hold on to the past. We really need to let the past go. It doesn't mean we don't want to honor the past, but we don't want to live in the past. When we have all these past memories kind of floating through our present moment, it really clutters the beautiful moments that we are having now. Because we're distracted, we're thinking about things that have happened at one time when we're trying to enjoy something that is happening right now. So we really just have to be mindful about how much time we're actually spending ruminating over the past or also worrying about the future. We want to keep our focus on the present moment, because this is the only moment we actually have control over. And this is the only moment that we actually always only have. So we want to make sure that we are giving it our full attention and our full focus at all times. Another thing we have to be careful about is information overload. We want to make sure that we're not stuffing our day and our brain with lots of media constantly and just lots of noise and lots of chaos. So we want to make sure that we are having time to turn off the phone, turn off the television, you know, turn off the radio, whatever it is, but have some quiet, peaceful time and unplug. Remember how precious our mental space actually is, so we want to only fill it with things that are actually relevant. So if we are constantly filling it with news stories that we don't care about or social media feeds from people we don't even really know anymore, it's really just not only wasting our time, but it's wasting that mental space that should be allocated for the things that truly bring us joy. So just remember to set limits for yourself and unsubscribe to things that really, again, aren't relevant for you anymore or really aren't that important. So you need to kind of see what makes the cut, keep that, and get rid of everything that's no longer important. And one of the most helpful things that we can do for ourselves is to set up routines. When we set up a routine, we have a strategy that is going to go on autopilot. When we have a routine, we are telling ourselves that we have something in our life that is important enough to be non-negotiable. So if we can set up routines regarding our fitness or our food or what we're going to wear, anything that we can waste a lot of mental energy kind of trying to make decisions over, if it can just be set up in a routine, saves that mental space. And it saves a lot of mental energy also, because it's already been decided. So we have figured out that these are the things that hold value to us. So they're going to be part of a routine that we do every single day. So we don't have to have the mental clutter of all these little things that are just kind of floating around in our head. We're going to set them up into set plans so we know that they are being handled and addressed in the most positive way possible. So these are all the different ways that I use to untangle my thoughts and to actually get the things that matter to me done. So I hope this is very helpful to you. I look forward to hearing which of these strategies you think will be most useful for you personally, and what things that you feel have been just kind of floating around in your head that you're actually going to go ahead and get accomplished. So I hope this video was helpful, and if it was, please like it, share it with someone else who may need to hear this message today, and also please become a subscriber if you aren't one already. I thank you so much for spending time with me today, and I truly hope you have an amazing day.